All right, we are recording. Sue, I'm so happy to be here with you on camera today.
Hi, Christian.
How is life down under?
It's a bit hot at the moment, but we're surviving.
Yeah, it's 6:30 Saturday evening here, and it's warm. I've got my ceiling fan going.
Yeah.
I'm sure all of our friends in cold places hate us right now.
Of course they do.
Thanks for hitting play on the video. Sue and I are here because we have some things on our minds that we thought might be interesting for you to hear. I think you know that either you know Sue or you know me, or maybe you know both of us a little bit. We've been around the block with this work from home stuff for a long time. And if you know either of us very well at all, you know that we mean well. I hope that you understand that. We have always meant well. We've never intentionally hurt people. However,
especially family and close friends, especially.
However, I'll just speak for myself. I have hurt a lot of people. I have. It was never my intention. And if I kind of rewind time in my head here for a minute, I stepped into the home business world as a naive kid. I didn't know up from down, left from right. I knew nothing at all. And I fell into some influences that in hindsight just weren't healthy. At the time, it seemed so good. and it wasn't, you know, my motive wasn't greed. My motive was so many other things, good things. But it didn't matter. It didn't matter. I ended up in these business models that just don't make sense. They never made sense, but I couldn't see it at the time. And that's what the predominant landscape right now in home business is still today. It's mostly junk. It's mostly hot garbage and bear traps.
Yep.
But so many people don't know. No. And we've been there, Sue. And I think a lot of our friends can identify with this. And if you've been sucked in by Sue and I, or Sue or I in the past, we apologize. Like, seriously, we do.
We're sorry. We're very, very sorry.
Yes.
Well, it's a timely reminder, Christian, because your comments then just reminded me of just one instance where a really, really close friend of mine, I got her into Zeek back when it was just firing. Yep. Firing, and everybody was jumping in, and it looked so brilliant because the business actually was three parts, and the part that I joined was a scam. It was an out and out pyramid scam, but by the marketing you couldn't understand the whole thing. So and my friend came in with $10,000, and then it folded like 2 months later before she could even recruit one person. I had recruited, I don't know how many I'd recruited, probably 20 or 30 or something like that. And fortunately, somebody pointed out to me, or there were some articles online, and I suddenly realized, hang on, this is a pyramid. It's not going to survive. And I got the money that I'd put into it out of it, and I told everyone, please get your money out. But you couldn't get it out quick enough. So she lost her 10 grand. Fortunately, the receivers were called in, and she got 3 grand back two years later. But in most cases, that hardly ever happens. So lots and lots of businesses. Over the 9 years I've been online, the first one that I really went nuts with was TBI Express, and that was supposedly a travel company, and I lost 10,000, and I actually was in a big Skype group, and when I was telling them before it went under and before the guy that was running it went to jail, I was telling the group that I was in, it's a scam, there's no holidays, I've been trying to get one, they won't give me one. No, well, they shouted and yelled, and I could not believe the anger, and I thought, I've been there. I've just been where those people are. I don't want it to be a failure. I want it to succeed. But if you looked at the numbers, if you look where the money was going, it was going nowhere.
Yeah. Yeah. If you follow the money, if you look at the emotion, that's another thing that's really common. And I've been there. I'm totally guilty of this. I threw myself. It was an emotional decision at the moment that things started over and over again for me. It was decisions made in a time of high emotion and logic. There wasn't really much room for logic. And I just wasn't thinking logically. I got sucked in. I got, Honestly, I'm a sucker for a good pitch. I always have been. So
I remember a video you made for Doobly, dare we say Doobly? And it was your video that I thought, oh my God, it sounds wonderful. And I jumped in too with you, you know?
Yeah.
After all of these failures, one of which really, really hurt me was Empower Network.
Ouch.
And there were a lot of really top people in Empower Network. And they were really, actually, I did learn a lot of mind stuff, a lot of how to behave, a lot of how to talk on camera, all that sort of stuff from that business. So I did learn something. Lost money, though, and everybody I brought into it lost money.
Yeah.
Where is it now? Where is it now? It was massive. They had conventions with thousands of people coming along to them.
Yeah.
Paying thousands of dollars to come, and it's gone. Disappeared.
Yeah.
Yep.
Like so many things. You know, I think a lot of this, I look back in hindsight, and I think a lot of the people, even at the very top, the founders and all of that, they meant well. I think in a lot of cases, now the scams are different, but the obvious scams are different. But a lot of these companies that really did try to serve people, I learned a lot in Empower Network also, most people lost their shirts, and it was a rough experience for most. You know, I look back and I go, I think most people mean well. It doesn't necessarily matter, though. You know, if you come across a person who's very, very sincere, let's just say that you're in some financial trouble or you're just not in a place financially where you want to be. And I know I just described like 97% of the global population. We're all like, yes, I would like some extra income, please, on a regular basis, like every month if possible. Yeah, I know, right? So most people identify with that. And I think what happens in home business most of the time, we kind of stumble along in the dark and we find somebody who is really sincere and really nice and they have a good sales video and we, you know, jump in. Later, it's not till it's too late usually, we realize, okay, I'm kind of drowning financially. I'm reaching for help. And the person I grab for help is also drowning. It doesn't matter how sincere they are. We're both dead. That's how the story ends.
That's it. The most recent example for me is Moeb. And that affected literally thousands of people. It was probably one of the biggest online businesses. Been around for 9 years. And the young guy that ran it, Matt Lloyd, was wonderful, wonderful man. He's only 30 now. He's got a lot of big future ahead of him still. But the FTC just closed it down overnight. And it was gone. And there were more than 500 employees relying on it for their daily income. Gone. Finish. Kapoof.
Wow. There's a lot of ways that businesses, forget about putting the word home in front of business. There's a lot of ways businesses fail every day around the world. Of course, home business is susceptible to the same thing. So, you know, why are we on camera yapping at our friends right now about all this stuff? I think a couple things. We want to admit to you that we have been naive in the past. We've fallen for things that didn't make sense. We see that clearly now.
Unfortunately.
And it's painful. And, you know, that's life. We all fail at lots of different things. If you don't try, I guess you won't fail at anything. But I don't think any of us want to live a life of not trying, right? So if you're watching the video with us and you're going, I've lost money. I've kind of had hopes and dreams and tackled things maybe with us in the past. And I've lost. If you identify with those things and you still have it in your blood, you know, like I want to find something that actually makes sense and do something. I'm just scared. Like I can't afford to lose my head again. Mm-hmm. My wife will kill me. My husband will kill me. My friends will kill me. You know, my bank will kill me, whatever it is. We feel your pain. We have been there. And we would ask, bring a skeptical, a strong, healthy skepticism, bring a logical, sound, critically thinking mind with you and look at what we have found.
Yep.
I think I can speak for both of us here and say what we're interested in accomplishing here is just look at the business model, look at the pitch for what Sue and I are both head over heels about right now. And analyze it for yourself. How does it make you feel? Is there any point in the presentation, the overview of what we have, where you go, that's stupid. Oh, you guys are pathetic. Oh, this is lame.
They're hiding something from me.
Yes. If there's any of that sort of thing going on, we would invite you, please, like, we're sincerely asking this, please talk with us. Like, no filters. Don't worry about offending us. Please lay it on us. I know some of our friends aren't afraid to really lay it on thick, but yeah. But if you'd be game to give us a shot at a logical, sane discord, maybe one where emotion is locked out of the room. Are Sue and I emotionally invested in what we're doing? Of course, we love
it. Absolutely.
Yes. And we like to love it, yes. But we can't put that in the other room and have a simple, logical conversation that I think would survive your skepticism. And what if it did? What if you looked at this critically and you went, okay, I'm trying to poke a hole in it and I can't. Pretty sure that's where you're going to land on this. If you do, then let's go have fun. Like, let's go actually make a difference in your family's finances, in mine, in Sue's, for the long term.
Yep.
That's
what I love about it, actually, the residual, more than anything else. Yes. That's what is, I'm so excited about it, really am, the residual. None of those other businesses I was in, well, one, if it was still around, I'd probably have some, but this one, how long has it been around?
33 years.
Yep. Still going and acting like a startup. So
yeah,
just growing like a weed.
Oh yeah. Yep. We have lots of fun stuff to show you. So, if you don't know me, and you know Sue, you know, just get back with her, ask her for a registration link. We have a private meeting that we do, or that we're doing, and you can, kind of just be a fly on the wall and sit in and observe. You can engage in the chat if you want to. It's not a kind of a meeting where we're on camera. We won't be able to see you or hear you, but you will be able to chat. And I'm being serious about kind of giving us a hard time, like really seriously show up with your, you know, critical thinking skills engaged.
Yep.
and you know, see what you think. I think you'll be happily surprised and you'll go, wow, okay. Even if you're not interested in what we're doing, at the end of it, I think your observation will be, wow, Sue, you finally got one right. Finally. All right. We sure have had our share of failures, but we're finally putting all of our education.
Christian, how long ago did you join this company?
It's been about 10 years.
Yeah. And you were only a customer all that time, and it's only 2 years ago you realized the income potential, residual opportunity.
Yep. Yeah, and I think that's an interesting angle. Maybe, Sue, let's do some other videos because this one's starting to get long. But in closing, a comment on a consumer note. If, you know, any business, you just look around the world at any business, I don't care, home business or not.
Yep.
Any business, a legitimate, viable, real business does what? It either fills a need, it serves real consumers somehow. It has to. Every business requires real customers. Otherwise, it's not a business. And a lot of the stuff we've done in the past doesn't even really pass that test. No. Unfortunately.
How did we fall for it, honestly?
I don't know. It's embarrassing. Anyway, we'd love for you to look at what we have going on. Again, just everything we've been saying, just bring your critical thinking with you. I'd be prepared to be surprised. So Sue, let's wrap up there. There's so much other stuff we could talk about, but I'm looking forward to doing some more. Okay. We're basically recording more of our conversations.
Absolutely.
All right. Sounds good. See you around. Yeah.